Hello students, the question, find the area bounded by two circles, x square plus y square equal to 4, the other circle x square and y minus 2 the whole square is equal to 4. If we take the first circle, f of x comma y is x square plus y square minus 4. This is f of x comma y. And if we change x by minus x or minus y, there is no change, so f of minus x comma minus y. And for the second circle, let us take g of x comma y, x square plus y minus 2 the whole square minus 4 is g of minus x comma y. If we change y by minus y, we won't get the same value. For g of x comma y and g of minus x comma y, both are equal. And x square plus y square minus 4 equal to both f of x comma y and f of minus x comma y. From this discussion, we can conclude the two circles are symmetric about, which is common. Here minus x, there also minus x, so symmetric about x equal to 0 or y axis. Symmetric about y axis. What is the first circle? Center 0, 0, radius 2 units. The second circle, center 0, 2 and radius 2 units. Anyhow, the two circles are congruent circles. The rough sketch. This is a circle and center 0, 0 and radius 2 units. So this is the point 0, minus 2, the other point 0, 2. The second circle, when x equal to 0 and 2 square 4 cancel, y also 0. So in the second circle passes through origin and through the center 0, 2, a radius 2 units. So this is circle, okay? This is second circle, this is first circle, and we have to decide the point of intersection of two circles. This is point of intersection, this is horizontal line through the point of intersection. Okay, to solve, the common term between the two circles, x square, then we can have, what is x square and 4 minus y square? X square equal to 4 minus y square from the first circle as well as from the second circle, x square equal to 4 minus y minus the whole square. And this implies 4 and 4 cancel, y square equal to y minus 2 the whole square. And this implies y square equal to y square minus 4y plus 4 equal to 4. After cancellation, and 4y equal to 4 and y equal to 1. So this is the line with the equation y equal to 1. Okay. Being the both the circles symmetric about the y-axis, we can take the lower limit, upper limit, or take this part. What is the area of this rectangular strip? So x1 first circle dy. The other one is with respect to second circle, x2 dy. So sum of these two from minus 2 to 0 into 2. Because of symmetric property, you have to multiply symmetric about the y-axis. Y-axis divide this area into two equal parts. So actually this is the required area. This is the required area. The required area can be evaluated with the help of the two integrations. Integral of x1 dy from 0 to 2 into 2 and integral of x2 dy from minus 2 to 0 into 2 using symmetry property. Okay, so the required area will be equal to the first integral. Y should be multiplied by 2 means because of symmetric property. The circle, two circles are symmetric about y axis means y axis divide this area into two equal parts with respect to the upper portion as well as the lower portion. So minus 2 to minus 2. Actually, this is 0, 0, no? 0 to 1. 0 to 1, x2 dy. Plus 2 times 1 to 2 x1 dy. Then 2, 0 to 1, x2 from the second circle. What is x2 from the second circle? Root of 4 minus of y minus 2 the whole square dy. Plus 2, 1 to 2, x1 from the first circle. And root of 4 minus y square dy. Okay. Dear student, to avoid two different integral, using properties of definite integral, we can combine the two integral as a single integral. And at the same time, seeing the nature of the area, we should not take 4 times area of one of the one of these four parts, 1, 2, 3, 4. So, finding area in this part into 4, the same answer will come, but without justification, we should not follow that. So, using properties of definite integral, we are going to justify these two are equal. Then we can combine. After combining these two as a single integral, we can integrate. For that reason, so let us take y minus 2 is equal to minus t, not plus t, minus t. If we take plus t, the lower limit, upper limit will be in negative quantity. Then application of properties of definite integral, and to handle properties of definite integral will be little bit difficult. For that reason, we can take y minus 2 equal to minus t, and this implies dy equal to minus dt. When x equal to 0, and t equal to 2 and x equal to 1, then t equal to 1. X equal to 1, t equal to 1 and dt. Applying the substitution in the definite integral and area is equal to 2 times. And what is corresponding lower limit? X equal to 0 mean 2. X equal to 1, then t equal to 1. Okay, root of 4 minus t square, this is minus dt. Plus 2 times, and 2, 1 to 2, root of 4 minus x square dx. Once again, applying the property. If we interchange lower limit and upper limit, minus dt becomes positive, plus dt, using properties. If we integrate in the reverse direction, the sign changes. So, minus dt now plus dt, 2. Why? Because I am going to interchange the upper limit and lower limit in right order. 1, 2, now plus dt, root of 4 minus t square, dt, plus 2 times. 1 to 2 root of 4 minus x square dx. Okay, and again using first property, what is first property? And p1 and 0 da f of x dx is equal to 0 da f of t dt. Same function, same interval, but the variable alone different, so final answer is going to be same. So, from using this property, these two are same. So, now we can combine 4 times 1 to 2 root of 4 minus x square dx. So, okay. So, dear student, we have combined these two integrals as a single integral. Now, 4 times 1 to 2, 4 minus x square. 1 to 2, 4 minus x square. So, knowing area of this part, multiplying by 4, we can get the total area. Then apply integral formula, root of a square minus x square, x by 2, root of a square minus x square, 4 minus x square, plus a square by 2. A square is 4, 4 by 2, 2. Sine inverse of x by a is 2. Only one term, 1 to 2. And 4 by 2. Can take 2, okay, and upper limit 4 minus 4 2 square, upper limit 0, lower limit minus 1 by 2, 4 into 1 by 2, 2 already x alone. So 1 and root of 4 minus 1 square root of 3, okay. So, this upper limit is 0, a lower limit minus 2 root 3, minus 2 root 3, plus 4 into 2, 8, upper limit sine inverse of 2 by 2, sine inverse of 1, pi by 2, minus sine inverse of 1 by 2, pi by 6. So, minus 2 root of 3, and pi by 2 minus pi by 6, pi by 3, 8 pi by 3. Okay, square unit. So this is area between the two given circle having the axis of symmetry x equal to 0 on y axis. So go through, student. We will meet in the next video class. Thank you.